Hey everybody, King Sam here. Happy New Year in advance. I'm going to show you guys how I created this Happy New Year animation right here in After Effects with no plugins. And remember, each video has helped you anyway. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. So let's jump right to the video. So this is how we're going to start from Adobe Illustrator, and there's a time lapse of how I separated this into individual folders right here on my channel because I downloaded it from FreePick. The link is in my video description, or if you want to work along with me without separating it, the link that is also in the video description. The next we're going to do is from our file explorer right here, we're going to drag into After Effects and import kind to be on composition, put the dimension should be on layer size. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to open my layer here. As you can see, imported and there's no background. So the first thing I'm going to do, we're going to create a background. So press Ctrl Y, open up the solid setting and click on OK. Now you go to Effect and Preset panel right here, and you're going to type in Gradient Ramp and apply it to your solid. Now this is your second color right here to bring it closer to brown, so something like this. I'm going to change this to Radial Ramp. I'm going to swap the colors, and we are just going to adjust position of our radial ramp like so. So now I'm just going to move this downward. That's looking cool. I think I'm just going to get this color that's inside here. Now we can zoom in back again. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to work on these balls here. Sorry. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to my pan behind tool here, and I'm just going to move our anchor points, all of them, to the top of our layer right here. I'm going to select ball 1, ball 2, and ball 3. And I'm going to come down to 1 second here. I'm going to click on pit of my position keyframes, and I'm going to make keyframe on their position. Now, let's just zoom in a bit more. I can come down to 15 seconds here. I'm going to make another keyframe on their positions. And come to the beginning of the timeline here, and I'm just going to drag them until they are outside your composition frame. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come down to somewhere around here, and I'm just going to move all this backward like this, move to the front around here, and I'm just going to drag all of them up again. Now if you look at it, you have this animation right here. So I'm just going to select everything here, but click F9 to use it, and I'm going to open up our graph editor. Now in my graph editor, I want it to, let's zoom in a little bit more so I can have final control. I want it to end slowly, so I can just drag this back. Now from here I can select this and zoom in again, use this. I'm going to push this forward like this. So let's play it back. Cool. So next I'm going to do is I'm just going to scatter them around. I don't want them to fall at the same time, so I'm just going to move this backward a little bit and just move this here. So now you have this animation looking cool like this. Okay, I think the end animation is happening too fast. I want it to be a little bit slower. I'll just move this back like this. Cool. And now I'm just going to this platform right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm first going to move it back. Let's see, it's around here. Open my position keyframes. And I'm just going to make a keyframe on the position here. Go back to the beginning of my timeline here. And I'm just going to move this downward. To select it, F9 to easy ease, and I'm just going to adjust my graph like this so it starts fast and ends slow. So now you have something like this that's looking cool. Now for this, my happy and new year, I'm going to click on T to open my opacity keyframes. Would come down to somewhere like here, make a keyframe on the opacity, move to the beginning of my timeline here, and I'm just going to take this down to 0. Now I'm just going to move these two of them back here, and I'm just going to make sure the happy starts first. So I want to make sure this thing's already seen, so I just move it, back like this. Okay, my knee is starting a little bit too fast, so I can just to change the timing. Cool. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to all this my layers here, so this 2025, and I'm going to open up my skill property right here, and I'm going to about 0.15 seconds here, and I'm going to make a keyframe on their scale. I'm just going to move it down like this, and here I'm going to change it to 110. Back to the beginning of my timeline here, and I'm just going to take this down to 0. So now you have this popping animation right here. Now I want it to like pop one after the other, so this is the first one. I'm going to leave that one. I'm going to start first. I'm just going to start arranging it like this so that it happens one after the other. First one here should come somewhere. So that's looking good. Okay, I want it to happen a little bit slower. And just move all this back a little bit. And this is my star layers here. I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm just going to open my scale keyframes and just come down here. Make a keyframe on my scale. Move keyframe forward. Change this to 110. Back to the beginning of my timeline here, and I can just take this down to 0. Now same thing, I'm just going to scatter when it triggers round. So let's see that again. Okay, this one now is, once it comes towards the tail end here, let's see that again. Now we're going to come to say like Pixabay, and we're going to search for videos in particular. I'm going to search for Confetti, and let's see. Okay, so I like this one right here. So we're just going to import that into After Effects right here. So next thing I'm going to do, we're going to hit F4 and toggle between modes, and we're going to be mode here and change it to screen. So when you play it back, you're supposed to have this. Okay, I think there's a little problem. Let's change this back to normal. So let's see what is the problem there. Yeah, so there's a problem here. I can just duplicate this, cut and duplicate, and when it's out of the way, do the same thing here, and I can just delete this part and just join these two parts together. So we're going to do the same thing, but now I'm going to change these two layers now to screen. Thank you for watching that video. Now that you have learned how to make this amazing animation, why don't you take a crack at learning this animation right here? Or you can take a crack at learning this other one, and I'll catch you in that video. And from now till the next year, remember, improve every day, grow constantly, and dream endlessly. I love you people. Happy New Year, everyone.
See you in 2025.
I'll do something, but nope. Same sushi.